The parametric drafting tools inside of AutoCAD are oftentimes overlooked, but they can provide an incredibly powerful toolset for creating dynamic blocks. For the CAD Geek, I'm Donnie Gladfelter, and in this video, I'm going to share with you how we can set up this desk block such that the secondary desk is always half the length of the primary segment of my desk. So in order to do this, I'm just going to begin by selecting on my desk, and I'm going to right-click and go into my block editor. Now, when I pick on this, it of course brings me into the block editing interface, and I can begin making this static block into a dynamic block. Now, in order to accomplish this, I'm going to use some of the parametric tools that I have at my disposal here. Now, I could set up all the geometric constraints manually, or what I can do is just use the super simple auto constrain feature that I have right here. Now, all I'm going to do is just select both segments of my desk and hit enter. And you can see that AutoCAD adds in the necessary geometric constraints here, so everything will stay parallel, perpendicular, all those good things. So at this point, what I want to do is add some dimensional constraints. Now, the interesting thing here is that dimensional constraints will also double as some of the dynamic properties in my final dynamic block. So the first thing I'm going to do is add a linear constraint here. So I'm just going to go ahead and pick on this guy. I'll go ahead and select right here to the left, and notice that little red circle that appears on the left-hand side. That's telling me what point I'm picking on within my geometry. So I'll go ahead and pick that point, and then for my second constraint point, I'll pick over here somewhere and drop that into place. So I'll go ahead and take the defaults there. I can change the name, but I'll go ahead and leave things as they are for now. So with the primary segment already dimensioned, I'm just going to do the exact same thing for the secondary segment here. So once again, up here on the dimensional panel, I'll click on my linear tool, and I'm just going to add a dimension in for this linear segment right here, and that's going to drop in a dimension of 3 feet. Now I've drawn this such that the length of this secondary desk is of course already half the length of the primary, but I want to make it so that if I stretch out the primary desk to maybe 8 feet, that this desk will automatically become 4 feet. So the way we can do this is we can actually reference the name of other dimensional constraints in my drawing. So in this case, I'm just going to say D2 is equal to D1, which is the name of this guy down here, divided by 2, and I'll hit enter. Now I can take this a step further if I want to add some additional intelligence in here. I can say the minimum distance for this is going to be 6 feet. And I can say that the distance type is going to be an increment. And I have to snap this to even increments of a foot. You can see it puts the little tick marks in there for me. So let's take a look at what this might look like. I'm just going to go into my test block tool right here, and that's going to let me work with this as if it were inserted into my drawing. So if I select on this, I get the one grip right here. You can see that it's currently 6 feet. And as I stretch this out, notice that this becomes 8 feet, this becomes 4. If I stretch this out, 10 feet and 5, and so forth. So as I stretch this out, the desk gets smaller, or larger, or smaller. So there you have it, a very simple way to apply parametric constraints to a dynamic block inside of AutoCAD. For the CAD Geek, I'm Donnie Gladfelter. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you soon.